Hello, today we have something very interesting to look at. This, what you see here right in front of you, is a professional Victron energy system, as it has been made for van builders, trucks, boats also. So if you use an isolation transformer on the input of this AC in, then you also have this as a system for marine applications. This is a standard that we are going to look at that I've been using throughout the world with different dealers. And today we are joined with the main dealer in this regards in Belgium, which is called Eberca Belgium. And the demonstration board you see right in front of you has been made by their technician, Bram. We have a lot of interesting things to look at, so let's get started. Here we have a closer view of the demo board. We'll discuss all these highlighted components. But first, I want you to notice something. If you look attentively, you'll see that this system is somewhat split in half. In this standard, we split the system into chargers and loads. This is the charger switch with its smart battery protect, and this is the load switch with its smart battery protect. In standby situations, such as a camper van driving from one destination to the next, the charger switch will always be switched on to charge the house battery, as we call it. The load switch will be off to greatly reduce parasitic consumption. Otherwise, it would quickly drain the battery. Only in the event of service or replacement or having to charge the starter battery, the charger switch must be switched off to prevent current going to the house battery instead of the starter battery. The load switch can be seen as a regular light switch in your living or working room. It is switched on when you're there with the need of electrical equipment, and you switch it off when you no longer need those consumers. The Multiplus is a special component in the sense that it is both a load and a charger. It is connected directly to the load switch, so never on the smart battery protect. Smart battery protects can only handle large current in one direction, that is, from the input to the output. You can see here what that means for the chargers, and here what it means for the loads. If you do not follow this convention, you will cause a fire, so be careful. We can control the functions of the Multiplus separately. For example, with a GX device such as a Servo GX, or with the inexpensive VE bus smart dongle that was used here. One question people have asked is, why do we use a battery protect for the chargers if we control them directly with the BMS? Well, there are a couple of reasons why we use two battery protects. The first is as a measure of fail-safe we learned in the overlanding market. When your installed chargers fail for whatever reason your adventurous life throws at you, and you need to emergency charge your smart lithium battery with a locally found external charger, it must still be possible for the BMS to switch it off when needed. Otherwise, you can easily damage your expensive battery in the field. This battery protect can do exactly that, as it is controlled by the BMS. A second reason of why we don't use remote on-off cables to a solar charger, for example, is because the smaller models only have a single data port. If you would connect a BMS signal to that port, you can no longer connect it to a GX device. Also, isolated Orions cannot be controlled directly on the remote port. They need a special cable. A final reason is to lower complexity and time when installing. We like to keep it simple, not, and I don't like this word, stupid or difficult to diagnose. Let's move on to the house battery. We use a Victron Smart Lithium battery with a VE bus BMS version 2. The BMS controls the Multiplus directly via data connection, and the two smart battery protects via voltage signals. The BMS comes with a mains detect box that is used for all Multiplus devices, except for the Multiplus 2 models. Any VE bus remote panels of your choice can be connected in the place where the smart dongle is connected here. Not far from the battery positive pole, the main fuse is installed. Other components all have a fuse closest to the most powerful energy source, usually being a battery. The Multiplus must be plugged into the power grid regularly to fully charge the battery for balancing purposes and to automatically calibrate the battery monitor to 100%. Here we have used the smart shunt to monitor the battery. Depending on the use case, it should be done weekly or monthly. The system ground is often tied to the chassis and motor block, and that should be the earth connection on the vehicle. We often use single connection points since these are easy to install in small places. The Multiplus conveniently has its own ground relay, which brings us to the residual current breakers. You need one on the shore input power and one on the AC1 output of the Multiplus. For the rest, this demo board features DC-DC charging using the new Orion XS 50 amps and solar charging using a 75/15 maximum power point tracker or MPPT with MC4 connectors indicating where the solar panels will be connected. At last, there is a fuse box and negative busbar installed to connect DC loads. Now, if you're looking for a cleaner system layout, you can also use a Lynx distributor to clean up some wiring. Some companies have a reputation of delivering stunning van conversions, and then the electrics must also be neat. Driftwood is such a company that makes beautiful builds in Belgium using natural materials. Here you can see an example of them using the Lynx distributor. If you also choose to do so, you'll need this little extra cable to light up the LEDs of the distributor. You can actually get a 5% discount on our website by using the code YouTube5. We can only ship to mainland Europe, and to make this up to the Americans watching, you get 5% discount on a broad range of electrical RV materials from RV solar connections by following the link in the description. At the end of this video, I'd like to do something fun as an inside joke between you and I to throw the early leavers off guard. This time, I encourage you all to comment "huh" to confuse the readers trying to find out what is so confusing. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please ask them in the comments, and please like and subscribe for more content and to help this little channel grow.